I'm not only the champion, I'm also the owner.
This is my idol here on the wall. I got a framed poster of him right over there.
Feel that? We got a man up today. Today is a very, very, very special day. What up, YouTube? This is Nate from ThriftDweller. Welcome back to Top 3 Tuesday. The greatest finds ever from the Wild Versus Edition. Today is very special, like I said, because of the opponent today. No, I'm not talking about Kuya Nate. Remember, Kuya Nate and me, Nate, are two separate entities. That guy's kind of a jerk. Nate is I'm a nice guy. But we're not talking about him today. Okay, guys? Mustache is disgusting. Today we're talking about the challenger. I'm very proud to say he is back, ladies and gentlemen. The man who needs no introduction in the modern world. Everyone knows his name from Polynesia to Canada. The reason I say YouTube had a soul, the creator himself of Top 3 Tuesday. Yes, he's come out of retirement. None other than EdT1138.
Hey guys, Ed here, and I'm posting a video for the first time in ages because Nate of the Thrift Dwellers had the audacity to challenge me to compare my top three finds in the wild to his. But then he went and ruined all my fun by challenging three other people, so in order to make this interesting, I decided I needed to find a way to similarly challenge myself. And what I've decided to do is take four rules that each of these finds needs to meet in order to make this list. The rules are as follows. Number one, it cannot have been found or given to me by someone else. Number two, I still need to have it in my collection. Number three, I need to have footage of the pickup in a video posted to my channel. And my personal favorite, number four, ThriftDweller Nate cannot have commented on the video, which is particularly insidious because he was a prolific commenter on my videos back in the day. Now, when it was all said and done, I ended up finding four videos that met all four criteria, and I've chosen three that, while certainly not my best finds, will hopefully be a challenge to Nate.
I'm excited. I'm really excited to see what this man's finds are. He held himself to the highest of standards, and I'm so proud of him. I'm also very fearful of him because this man is dangerous. You think he's a nice guy. His balls are square. We do not know what he is capable of. For his top three list, this is going to be exciting. But before we dive into that, we have to find out what Kuya Nate, remember, I'm not Kuya Nate, he's a separate entity, what he has to say about this. He does not know he is fighting this guy. He pre-recorded his video. So let's just hear from him now. In life, some people are lucky. Some people say this mustache is lucky. I believe you make your own luck in life. Today's top three list is based on that thrift store luck. These are my top three luckiest finds from the thrift store. I'm sure there's going to be like another list from the thrift store, but this is the first one, the first video I'm ever shooting. So lucky you, or unlucky you, bask in my glory. I hate that. I don't think Kuya Nate held himself to as high a standard as EdT1138, or as I incorrectly called him, EDT1138.
What's up, YouTube? Thrift Dwellers here. Lester.
Nate. We're here to do EDT1138.
EDT1138 held himself to a higher standard in this list. Will that save him? I implore everybody to keep that in mind when you decide on who had the best finds in this video. Remember, EDT1138 said, I could not have seen his pickups before. I used to watch this man's channel like... He was one of the few people I followed religiously, even more than Angry Video Game Nerd, even more than Millennium Falcon Console Gamer. Kuya Nate wants to retire The Undertaker. Ironically, he retired this year, so maybe that's an omen, maybe that's a sign. Let's get into it. The Battle of the Titans. Kuya Nate versus EdT1138. Third pick. We'll go into both of theirs.
Okay, a couple of quick caveats here. First, you're going to see me reading from a list over here. It's because I'm old and apparently I can't do the stuff off the cuff anymore because my memory's terrible. Second, you're going to notice that these are bundles, but Nate and the others had bundles in their videos too, so I figured it was all right. Now, number three is from a video titled The Facebook Only Pickup Video, which, as the name implies, was a Facebook Only Pickup Video that I eventually ended up posting to my YouTube channel. I think that might be why Nate didn't comment on it, but this one isn't terribly interesting, except for the fact that I haven't found anything in this Goodwill for a very long time, and I haven't found anything in it since I found these games. But on this particular day, when I walked in the front doors, I noticed all the way at the back of the store was this gray three-tiered cart, and on top of it were bundled jewel cases. And you don't typically bundle music CDs, so I figured they were either games or just loose cases. When I got back there, there were several bundles of PlayStation games and I think one bundle of Dreamcast games. I ended up picking up two bundles of the PlayStation games for $6 a piece, and then the one Dreamcast bundle for $5. The PlayStation games are as follows. Had Rage Racer, Final Fantasy VIII, both the Greatest Hits and Black Label version, Final Fantasy IX Black Label, Parasite Eve, Resident Evil 2, Dino Crisis, and Tekken 2. According to price charting, the total for the PlayStation 1 games would be about $185 today. For the Dreamcast games, I had Sonic Adventure, Walt Disney World Quest Magical Racing Tour, Star Wars Racer, Frogger 2, Swampy's Revenge, and Namco Museum. According to price charting, the total for that was $119. The total spent was $19. The total value, according to price charting again, is $304. Not great, but it's number three.
Now I'm going to take you back, way back. The summer of 2013. If you want to check out a really old pickup video from Thrift Dweller, check out Raw Pickups 58. We've been in this game a long time. Video quality might not be so good. Audio quality is definitely horrible. But in that video, this particular find benefits from the years that have passed by, boosting up its monetary value. But for me, it's one of my favorite games on the Nintendo. At Value Village, I found for $3.99 in a bag hanging on the wall, Batman, Return of the Joker. Loose, but it's okay. At this point in my collecting career, I haven't found this yet in the wild. I haven't picked it up yet, so it was an addition to the collection. It's still on the shelf. Please remember, all prices are in Canadian. The value of this game on price charting, loose American, which is 30% more than Canadian, $50.50. Lucky find number one, just like that. Fun game. Great game. Beautiful cover on this game. That is number three on my list. The next one, number two. It looks like NT1138 went a little monetarily based for his first submissions on this list. Again, he held himself to a higher standard. I respect that. We're not worthy. We have to compare. I don't think Guionade is holding back here. Return of the Joker is a banger. That's a heavy hitter. That's a big gun, and I wouldn't expect any less going up against the Titan. The Kronos of this mythology that is Thrift Dweller, NT1138. If you don't know what I'm talking about, study your damn history. We're going to get into it. Here's number two on NT1138's list of his greatest finds ever from the wild.
Now, for number two, this is a mouthful, but I'm going to read the entire title. Thrift Store Video Game Pickups, and a Friend Convinces Me to Blow My Christmas Money. I don't know how I can describe it any differently from that, but this one was another Goodwill store. What makes this one interesting is it was about 500 feet from a video game store. But on this day, I walked in, and right in front of the door was a glass case filled with bundles of video games. It's right as I walk up to the case, but I ended up buying a bundle of Sega Genesis games and two bundles of NES games that I also had a 35% off coupon. The breakdown was $1.30 per game. John Elway Quarterback, Super Mario Brothers Duck Hunt, found three of those. Tetris, Tennis, Silent Service, Solstice, WrestleMania, Airwolf, Jeopardy 25th Anniversary Edition, Fester's Quest, Bayou Billy, Rad Racer, Rad Racer 2, Snoopy's Silly Sports, Back to the Future, Section Z, The Little Mermaid, Bases Loaded, Guerrilla War, The Moffat Conspiracy, Tiny Toon Adventures, Dr. Mario, Yoshi, Super Mario Bros. 3, Mario is Missing, Super Mario Bros. 2, Mario Machines, The Legend of Zelda 5 Screw, and the total according to price charting for the NES games was $295. For the Genesis, these are all complete in box. There was Wheel of Fortune, RBI Baseball 3, Columns, Jurassic Park, The Lion King, Sonic 2, Gadget Twins, Vector Man, Sonic 3, Crackdown, Battletoads and Double Dragon, the Ultimate Team Up, I think, Garry's, and Streets of Rage 3. Now, according to price charting, Streets of Rage 3 all by itself is worth about $225. Garry's is about $130. The Genesis total, according to price charting, is $581. The total I spent with the discount ended up being $50. The total value is $876. So there you go.
I think we need the chairman's ruling. Chairman? I guess, you know what? Going forward, if you found the video game item or items in the same day that you went to the thrift store or in the wild, whatever spot it was, bundles will be allowed. I'm saying NT1138 is taking it to the extreme, man. Goddamn. That's a... My mouth dropped when I was watching his, like him explaining his list. My mouth dropped. That's a pretty good, like, day. That reminds me of the days when YouTube had a soul and the thrift stores were, you know, the solid good old days. They weren't like they are now. Let's check in with Queen 8. Number 2 on Queen 8's list. This is the next one. Number 2. Taking you back, way back. 2012 summer. I think it was featured in a pickup video. If you want to check out that pickup video, please don't. It is horrible. I almost rather not link it in the description below. In that pickup video, we showed from Value Village a very rare find that we haven't come across since. First time we ever came across it at that time for $12.99, all taped together with a controller and a game in the slot. A TurboGrafx-16. Damn right I said it. TurboGrafx-16. $12.99. Came with Keith Courage, which when we were testing the system, Lester and I were like, man, this is actually a really good game. This whole console is really good. Funny thing is, since I tested it at that time, I maybe busted it out twice or three times in the nearly decade that I owned it since I got it. You know how many elbow drops that is? You can't recover from that many elbow drops. But the Power Fist comes with the number one on my list. I'm really excited you guys get to witness this journey with me. Number two, dollar for dollar, NT1138 was higher. But really what matters is what you think, your perspective as the viewer in the comments below. What are you, you know, looking at? What are you judging? What is your criteria? Everyone is unique. And that was the point of like this whole series that we're doing. You guys get to judge it however you want to judge it. Take into account whatever you want to take into account. Let me know in the comments below. Who goes first? I think we should always save the final word. Going forward will be the challenger. Okay? Queen 8 will always go first on like the number one picks. He will show his first and the final word, as gracious as we are in this federation, in this league, will always be the challenger. So Queen 8 first. Number one on the greatest find from the thrift store, according to this video. But the Power Fist comes with the number one on my list. The last one, the TurboGrafx-16, that was maybe a little bit more monetarily based. Yes, I enjoyed it, but this final on my list, number one, is actually one of my favorite games ever. Way back. This is prehistory. This is from the book of Thriftdweller Genesis, before anything in existence existed. There was Nate going to the thrift store in 2010. One day I went to Value Village, and this day was just one of my luckiest days ever. Really kickstarted my Sega Genesis collection, because at that time I had maybe like two shoeboxes of games. And they had a bunch of boxed with manual Sega Genesis games on the shelf. 99 cents, a buck, Canadian buck. That's 70 cents in America. I have it on the shelf. What could it be? All the way from 2010 to today, Michael Jackson's Moonwalker. Some of the best chiptune music ever in the history of video games. It even has the date on there, 2010, 99 cents. Totally different than any other game at that time that I played, even today. You know, kind of a beat 'em up, but not. You're defeating people with music. You're playing hide and seek with children. You're saving them from Mr. Big. It is mind-blowing. It is a beautiful game. Better than the arcade. Damn right I said it. And there you have it. From the King of Pop to the King of Thrift. My top three for video number one. The top three greatest finds from the wild. Video number one. How do you like them apples? Hope you came with it. Hope you came correct. This is Nate from Thrift Dweller throwing it back to you, Nate. How fitting. How fitting is it that he chose this video, this list, you know? I agree with Queen 8. It's one of my favorite games. Has the best chiptune music in all the Sega Genesis library. Yes, I said it. It has Thriller. Thriller. ET1138, I'm very interested to see what is his number one pick on his list for his top find from the wild. This should be good, guys. Strap in.
And finally, number one is from a video titled The Start of a New Collection, and the story begins with me on my lunch hour perusing Craigslist. Ended up finding a listing that I was really interested in that was about 10 minutes down the road, and here is what I found. They refused to hold them for me until after work, but they did agree to take 50% up front and then 50% when I came back to pick them up. So I ran to the ATM machine, got the money, paid them their 50%, left to work about 2 hours early, got my little brother's truck, got my friend Eldon in his truck, for the cost of Taco Bell dinner, which I'm sure he later regretted after he realized how much work this was going to be. We went back to get the arcade machines only to find out that we couldn't take them out the back door because they had a chain link fence and no gate. So you'd have to lift these cabinets over the fence, which was not going to happen. That left us with one option. Take them up a flight of stairs, across a narrow walkway, and then through the kitchen. Now, we ended up not using the dolly that you see in this picture here when we stopped for dinner later at Taco Bell. We ended up using these moving blankets, and what we had to do was lay the arcade machines on their back, slide them across this really cheap laminate floor without scratching it, go up the narrow flight of stairs with the wrought iron handrail, across the platform, stand them upright, turn them 90 degrees, go through the door, down around a 90 degree corner, between cabinets and a kitchen island, about 15 feet, where we had to turn them 90 degrees again, lay them down, carry them out the door, set them in the back of the truck. Took us about 2 hours. The wife came out and said, I can't believe you guys got those out of here. Nobody has wanted to do this. And I said, what do you mean nobody has wanted to do this? She said, well, we've tried to sell them several times over the years. The last time was about 7 months ago. We were asking $500 a piece for them. And the only person that came to pick them up, when they got here and saw what they had to do to get them out, decided they didn't want them anymore. I got both of these cabinets for $100. And according to Exidy's price guide, because I didn't want to use eBay, Super Cobra is worth between $500 and $750. And Zaxxon is worth between $800 and $1,200. So if you take the low end, it ends up being about $1,300. I paid $100 and then I paid an additional $40 in bits and pieces to repair them. So for $140, I got, at the low end, $1,300 worth of arcade cabinets. And Zaxxon is one of my favorite Sega arcade games, and you can see it sitting right back there. That thing was near pristine. I ended up buying a new control panel overlay for $14.99, I think, and I had a couple of new locks laying around. But that thing is, aside from the control panel overlay and the locks, all original, and it's in really good shape. Super Cobra is right over here. That one worked when I first got it home, but I ended up actually buying a 60-in-1 arcade board, replacing the monitor with an LCD screen, and I put a new control panel in it that had a trackball to go with the 60-in-1 board, but I have all the original parts. I have since repaired the sound issues on the board just by taking it apart, cleaning everything, and putting it back together again. I recapped the monitor, and the control panel is all original. It's inside the arcade cabinet over there, so I can make that one original anytime I want. Both cabinets are really nice. Now, I paid $100 and then I paid an additional $40 in bits and pieces to repair them. So for $140, I got, at the low end, $1,300 worth of arcade cabinets. And one of them happens to be my second favorite Sega arcade cabinet after Frogger. So there you go, Nate. That is number one. I'm losing my voice because it's about 5:30 in the morning. And I'm very tired. If you can beat that, good for you.
This is why I wanted to continue Top 3 Tuesday. This is why I made the Versus series. I love stories like that. You know, no matter what the outcome of this battle is, of course, the majority of it is in your hands and our crooked... I mean, sorry, Chairman. Our very fair Chairman over there. He will do a follow-up video. He'll actually make an appearance. We'll review all the comments people put, all the votes. Of course, this is totally crooked rules. Like, we don't have a rule book, okay? You could call this the twin galaxies of the Versus series of Top 3 Tuesday. I'm not only the champion, I'm also the owner. This is my idol here on the wall. I got a framed poster of him right over there. This essentially was the final boss at T1138, the final Versus series of this season. We have some new competitors for next season, but I think this is a good end cap. We will make a video following up who won against Ed, who won against That Dallas Thrifter, who won against KMD Baby, and who won against Team G Sale. But yeah, stay tuned to the channel for that. Let us know in the comments below who you think won, and just feel blessed that we were able to see this almost full circle. You know, 2012 to 2020, what a good way to end the year, just in time for Christmas. It's a Festivus miracle. And you are great. Thank you very much for watching the channel. Don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out the subsequent videos following this one, following up who won, and all that jazz. Thank you very much for joining us. Happy holidays, guys. Whatever you celebrate, whoever you are, wherever you are in the world, Thrift Dweller wishes you nothing but the best in 2021. So we bid you adieu, goodbye, and farewell. There's a joke in the Filipino community. It's like, pogi means handsome. So where does handsome, or where does pogi keep his gun? Right here. This is a good video. This made me really happy, guys.